the events following the crucifixion. And we're going to talk about God
moves. God moves. Matthew 27:51 says, "And behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain from top to the bottom." Mark 15:38 says, "And the veil of the temple was rent in twain from the top to the bottom." Luke 23:45 says, "And the sun was darkened, and the veil of the temple was rent in the midst." These three gospels all carry the same course of events. The veil of the temple was torn in two during the crucifixion, following Jesus' death. Now, during the lifetime of Jesus, the holy temple in Jerusalem was the center of worship for God's people. The temple was the place where the animal sacrifices were carried out, and worship according to the law of Moses was followed faithfully. In the temple, the veil separated the Holy of Holies, which was the earthly dwelling place of God's presence, from the rest of the temple where the men dwell. This veil signified that man was separated from God by sin. Only the high priests were permitted to pass beyond the veil once each year to enter into God's presence on behalf of the people. When Jesus died, something major happened. Something major happened after the crucifixion, after Jesus died. First of all, the veil was torn from top to bottom. This was a thick piece of material, about 6 inches thick, about 40 feet high, and it was torn from the top to the bottom. The second major thing that happened that people don't talk about is God moved. He moved out of the temple, never to dwell in a place that was made by man's hands ever again. And we say, well, how can God move? Was he every place? And when they set up the temple, God's dwelling place was behind the veil in the Holy of Holies. That's where God was. The people came to God for sacrifice. After Jesus died, after the crucifixion, God moved out of the Holy of Holies into the hearts of men and women everywhere. So the major event was that God moved. Now Jesus is our high priest, and we can now enter the Holy of Holies through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We don't need to sacrifice animals anymore. We don't need to sacrifice things anymore to God. He is in our heart because he moved out of the Holy of Holies into us, into the living temple. We can enter into the Holy of Holies because God moved. And whenever you move, it's always a major event. Nobody moved just to move. Either the place is too big, it's too small, or you want to get in a better location. God figured that he's not going to be in the temple where man's hands are made. He wants us to be the living temple, so he was going to move in us. So when Jesus died and the power of the Holy Spirit came upon us, God was able to dwell in us today. So when God moves, people notice. The soldier, Reverend Walker already talked about how the soldier noticed after the crucifixion. He said, this must be the Son of God. Wasn't acknowledging it before, but he's acknowledging it now. The people noticed that things were done. They noticed the veil was rent from top to bottom. They know that no man could have just jumped up there and tore the thing down. So they noticed that. So things were noticed. And today, if we are still living after the crucifixion, things are still happening because God moved. The reason why we do the things that we do and miracles are with God's people is because God moved. He doesn't live in a temple. He lives inside of you. He lives inside of me. All because God moved after the crucifixion, we can do what we do. And today, church, let me just tell you, God is still moving. Oh, yes. Amen. Amen. Because you're moving, and you're praying, and you're believing, and you have faith, and you have joy, and you have peace, and you have patience, and all the other fruits that God gave you, God is still moving because he's moving inside of you. Amen? Amen. Amen. want to pray for yourself. You might just want to come to the altar and say, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you for everything that you've done for. You might want to thank the Lord for somebody else that is probably not here. I don't know what's on your heart today, but I'm going to open the altar up right now. For whosoever will, you may know. Thank you.
we have to walk through this fire so we can appreciate many of the souls. So Lord, as we continue in our worship experience, we give you all praise, honor, and glory that we have heard something that will contain our hearts and bless someone along the way during this season. In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, let the church say, amen. Thank you. years, Good Friday service was the prayer child of Reverend Delaire and Reverend Walker. The Lord told my heart to let them do the Good Friday service this year. So it was totally there for every child.
Amen.
That's why I was only trying to figure out what they wanted to do, because I wanted to do what they wanted to do. So God bless them.
Amen.
And I'd like to thank our youth. Amen. For doing the service and the Lord. And I'd like to thank our ushers.
Amen.
Whenever the ushers do a service, they always get early and they always get ready. Amen. But don't step wrong, because the ushers be stepping right. And the men's chorus. And also Mrs. Winterberry, Mrs. Walker, all the way back up with the word of prayer. Amen. The tech team. Kim. Amen. For running the video for the scripture. Did y'all like that? Amen. And Matthew, always and always in our heart. And Brother Etten is probably one of the most faithful. Well, outside of Matthew. Well, Matthew for another reason. But Brother Etten is probably one of the most faithful musicians that I've ever run across in my life. Amen. And I just thank you for being with me. Get that on YouTube, Brother Etten, that's it. Amen. And God bless each and every one of you being here tonight. I mean, if you were here and blessed, just say amen.
Amen.
Amen. It's always a blessing to be in the house of the Lord, especially during this season, and we know what we're coming up to celebrate on Sunday. So I just thank you and God bless all of you for your attendance and your presence and for taking a part in the life of this church. And right now, I'm going to turn it over to Reverend Hillel. Remember that Reverend Hillel said it.
Amen. I'd also like to just extend my gratitude. I'm so very proud of them. I think it's important that as they learn new stuff, that we teach them some of the old stuff that we grew up with. And so I wanted to include some of the spirituals we had today. Let us prepare our hearts and minds for the new age. God, be merciful unto us and bless us.